Welcome to this live double eviction episode of Big Brother Extreme. Tonight, we will play an entire round's worth of Big Brother, all on the same night. Just to clarify, first things first, we will have the first live eviction to where either Darshan or Inez will be evicted from the house. We will then have the live head of household competition, directly immediately followed by live nominations. We will then have the live power of veto competition, directly followed by the live veto meeting. We will then have a second live eviction, and a second house guest will be evicted from the house. We are in for a rather long night, so we don't have any time at all to waste. So, let's go to the live house right now. House guests, this is Big Brother. May I have your attention, please? House guests, Big Brother wants you all to know that this is a double eviction night. An entire round of Big Brother will be played all tonight. We will go on ahead with the eviction tonight, but another house guest will be leaving very soon after that. House guests, after the first eviction, we will play live competitions, have live nominations and meetings. Then, a second eviction will take place as well. House guests, Big Brother wants you to know that Big Brother is free to shake up the setup of the game and add twists to the game anytime he feels like. Big Brother decisions are all final. Big Brother appreciates you all as house guests. But, house guests, Big Brother is not keeping you captive at all. If you don't like it, the front door is right there, and you are free to leave the game. Understanding you give up your right to the prize money, you will not be able to go to the sequester house, will not be allowed a jury vote, and also, you will not be allowed back at finale. House guests, do you all understand? Great. Then we don't have much time to waste, so let's get on with it. House guests, in a few short moments, either Darshan or Inez will be evicted from the house. You all will go into the diary room and cast your votes to evict live. However, Darshan and Inez, this is your last and final chance to sway your fellow house guests to keep you in the game. Darshan, you are up first. Inez, you are up next. Okay. House guests, in alphabetical order, each of you will go into the diary room and cast your vote to evict. Brad, as head of household, you are not allowed to vote. The two nominees are not allowed to vote either. Chantel, please go to the diary room. Chantel, who do you vote to evict? Dylan, who do you vote to evict? Gus, who do you vote to evict? Jason, who do you vote to evict? It's official. Inez has been evicted from the Big Brother house. But, let's see how the rest of the house voted. Miles, who do you vote to evict? Neil, who do you vote to evict? Scott, who do you vote to evict? Houseguests, once I reveal the votes, the evicted houseguest must immediately say their goodbyes and walk out of the front door. By a unanimous vote, Inez, you have been evicted from the Big Brother house. Let's hear it, for Inez. Inez, are you surprised that you have been evicted from the house? Why do you suppose the house kept Darshan over you? Is there anything that you would have done differently? Inez, you seemed very quiet in the house. Is there anyone at all you wish to keep in contact with on the outside? Final question. Because you are a jury member, without revealing who you are going to vote for, what will you be basing your jury vote on? Inez, you were a great house guest. But, it is now time for you to go to the jury sequester house. You will return here on finale night, where you will vote for this season's winner. Thank you. Double eviction night is just getting started. After the break, we get to the live head of household competition. Stay tuned. Welcome back. Now, let's get to the live head of household competition. Houseguests, this is double eviction night. We are playing an entire round's worth of Big Brother, all tonight. Houseguests, the head of household power is up for grabs. Brad, as outgoing head of household, you are not eligible to compete. Houseguests, the head of household receives immunity from eviction for this round. However, they must nominate two houseguests for eviction. This is double eviction night, so they will nominate immediately after the competition ends. Houseguests, this is how this head of household will commence. Houseguests, Big Brother's assistants, which by the way, I have many, and my assistants help Big Brother form the entire program, from setting up challenges, coming up with twists, and if I tell my assistants to go get me something to eat, or a cup of coffee, they have to do that as well. But my assistants and I have a great relationship. So much that I found out, a couple of my assistants have a podcast that they told me to go watch. Big Brother was watching a recent episode of their podcast, and I thought, this would be a great competition idea. Houseguests, I will show you an excerpt of Big Brother's assistants podcast. Pay close attention to every detail, even if you think it's trivial or mundane, pay attention to it anyways. Once the clip is finished, I will ask several true or false questions. Get the question correct, you remain in the game. Get the question incorrect, you are eliminated from the competition. If there are still contestants left, after the first clip, I will play a second clip, and the format continues. The last houseguest standing wins head of household. If there is a tie after the end of all of my questions, we will resort to a tiebreaker question. Houseguests, do you all understand? Great. I will now show you the first clip of my assistant's podcast.
I found his clip. Okay, let me ask you if you agree with this or not. Many people look at old footage of like different eras, like the 90s, 80s, 70s, whatever, and think that people in those eras look older at younger ages than they do now.
I agree with that.
Yeah. Look older, and mm-hmm. then nowadays they look younger. So anyway, this post is, now I understand why teens look like 30-year-olds in the movies. And this is a Reddit post, but there's a video clip which looks like a kind of amateur video from a high school in the 90s. And you can play some of it here. So these are I don't know about the music. You don't need it. These are high school students in the 90s.
Oh my God. The way that they dress is very 90s. But their face looks very old.
Right.
They look like they're in their 30s.
So you agree then?
Yeah.
Now, which guy here do you feel looks the oldest?
It was the thumbnail guy.
This guy?
Oh, was it that guy?
Or which guy? Oh, the guy in the...
this guy.
This guy, yeah.
This one looks like someone's dad or something.
Like, there's a lot of shaving going on there.
I think mainly because his jaw is chiseled or something.
Now, there's a lot of, how about these dance moves right here, by the way?
Oh, yeah. Classic.
There's a couple things I want to mention about this clip. So, first of all, yes, the individuals that were chosen in this clip are definitely older looking. However, I think it's important to note that probably the more popular individuals would probably be more likely to turn towards the camera or be featured in the video. And sometimes that means that those are the, those could be the jocks or sports enthusiasts or whatever who.
Question one. Both podcasters were wearing a red sweatshirt. Answers, please. The correct answer is false. One podcaster was wearing a red sweatshirt. The other was wearing a white sweatshirt. Everyone got it correct. Everyone remains in the competition. Question 2. Both podcasters had on black baseball caps? Answers, please. The correct answer is true. Everyone got it correct. Everyone remains in the competition. Great job, house guests. Question 3. There was a group of students, one male and one female, seen hugging. Were they both wearing white shirts? Answers, please. The correct answer is false. The female was wearing a black shirt. The male was wearing a white shirt. I am so sorry, Gus, but that is an incorrect answer. You have been eliminated from the competition. Question 4. There was a female holding a camcorder. Her bandana she was wearing was colored blue? Answers, please. The correct answer is false. The bandana she was wearing was colored red. I'm so sorry, Scott, but that is an incorrect answer. You have been eliminated from this competition. Question 5. There was a female seen dancing in the hallway. During her dance, her left arm was out? Answers, please. The correct answer is true. I am so sorry, Darshan and Jason, but that is an incorrect answer. You have been eliminated from this competition. Question 6. One of the podcasters said, one of the students looks like someone's uncle? Answers, please. The correct answer is false. The podcaster said that he looks like someone's dad. Everyone got it correct. Everyone got it right. Everyone remains in the competition. Fantastic. Well done, house guests. Well, those are all my questions for this clip. Let's get to the second and final clip, please.
Working out or lifting weights or whatever. It's not going to be the introverted types. And this is the conversation, the Reddit thread, that maybe there was like a kind of skew to the type of people featured in the video.
Right.
Now, the other thing to mention, these dudes look 27. Yeah, some of them do. The other thing to mention is clothing, which you already mentioned.
Yeah.
Clothing can really influence you because when you see it as an older style or a style that you would normally see on somebody older now or more recently, then you just kind of make that association. But here's the other piece that I want to add to it. No smartphones. So when you look at their reaction to the camera, they all kind of like put on a little show because they're not used to being on camera. Nobody's like, hey, get the camera away from me.
Yeah.
Nobody's like, hey, don't point that at me. They're all kind of into it in a different way because there's not smartphones all over the place in the 90s. So it's a whole different atmosphere. It's a whole different vibe. They're having a time. There's a lot of smiling going on. I'm not going to lie.
Uh-huh.
It's a lot of smiling. Now, other people said that maybe because they're not playing a bunch of video games and stuff, maybe they're also outdoors more often. Maybe they're doing more physical activity because of that.
Hmm.
And so, because they're all in good shape, too. Like, you got to be noticing this.
Yeah.
Like, you can't find...
And it's like a number of reasons, like you said. It's not just one.
Maybe. But there's a lot of speculation. Now, people say that maybe it's also, it could be like a weird perception thing that we have. That if you grew up in the 2000s or something, then people in the 90s look old. And if you grew up in the 90s, people in the 80s look old. Older or whatever, you know, this kind of weird like time shift that takes place.
Question 7. One of the viewers in the live stream comments said the students look 25. Answers, please. The correct answer is false. The viewer in the live stream comments said the students look 27. Everyone got it correct. Everyone remains in the game. Great job. Question 8. There was a male student with a red shirt, giving the peace sign. Was he raising up the peace sign with both of his hands? Answers, please. The correct answer is true. I am so sorry, Chantel, but that is an incorrect answer. You have been eliminated from this competition. Question 9. The podcaster said, there is a lot of smiling going on? Answers, please. The correct answer is, true. Everyone got it correct. Everyone remains in the competition. Fantastic. Well done. Question 10. The podcaster said the students look old because they are not staying at home on the internet and stuff? Answers, please. The correct answer is false. The podcaster said, because they play video games and stuff. I am so sorry, Dylan, but that is an incorrect answer. You are eliminated from this competition. Question 11. The podcaster said the students look old because they are all in good shape? Answers, please. The correct answer is true. That means, congratulations, Miles, you are the winner of the head of household competition. Miles, please announce who your nominations are, now please. Miles won the head of household competition and nominated Darshan and Jason. The live power of veto competition is up next. Please stay tuned. Welcome back. Now, let's get to the live power of veto competition. Houseguests, welcome to the power of veto competition. Only 6 houseguests will compete. Miles, the current head of household. Darshan and Jason, who are nominated for eviction. Also, 3 housemates selected by random draw. They are Dylan, Neil, and Scott. Houseguests, for this competition, each of you will pick a ball pit. you must quickly search through your pit until you find a golden ring. If you find the golden ring, immediately put it on your finger and race to the podium. The first houseguest to find the ring isn't necessarily the winner, but the first to get the ring, wear it around their finger, and approach the podium will win the power of veto. Houseguests, do you all understand? Great. The competition begins now. Congratulations, Dylan. You are the winner of the power of veto. Houseguests, please immediately report to the living room for the veto meeting. Dylan, please stand and announce your decision. Okay, houseguests. We will have the eviction very shortly. When we come back, we will have the second live eviction. Please stay tuned. Houseguests, you already know what time it is. That's right. Eviction time. Houseguests, each of you will go into the diary room and cast your vote to evict either Darshan or Jason. Gentlemen, this is your last and final chance to speak with the house. Darshan, you are up first. Jason, you are up next. Okay. Houseguests, in alphabetical order, all of you will go into the diary room and cast your vote to evict, live. Miles, as head of household, you will only vote in the event of a tie. The two nominees are not allowed to vote. Brad, please go to the diary room. Brad, who do you vote to evict? Chantel, who do you vote to evict? Dylan, who do you vote to evict? Gus, who do you vote to evict? It's official. Jason will be evicted from the house. But let's see how the rest of the house voted. Neil, who do you vote to evict? Scott, who do you vote to evict? Houseguests, once I reveal the vote, the evicted houseguest must immediately say their goodbyes and walk out of the front door. By a unanimous vote, Jason, you are evicted from the Big Brother house. Let's hear it for Jason.
In the cool of the evening, when everything is getting kind of groovy, I call you up and ask you if you'd like to go with me and see a movie. First you say no, you got some plans for the night, and then you stop and say,
Jason, are you surprised that you have been evicted from the house? Why do you suppose the house kept Darshan over you? Is there anything that you would have done differently? Will you keep in contact with Darshan? Final question. Because you are a jury member, without revealing who you are going to vote for, what will you be basing your jury vote on? Jason, you were a very entertaining and great housemate. But it is now time for you to go to the jury sequester house. You will return here on finale night, where you will vote for this season's winner. Thank you. Double eviction night is now over. What a wild ride and wild rush. Who will be the next to leave the house? Find out very soon on Big Brother Extreme.